The Silent Garden Program at Fresno State provides educational programs, workshops, and resources to the deaf and hard of hearing community here in Central California. And that includes an upcoming statewide summit on educational interpreting. Here with all the details is Janice Smith-Warshaw. She is the director of deaf studies at the program there at Fresno State. Joining her is Eddie Reyes. He's an interpreting student. And behind me right now is Erin Reese. She's an American Sign Language interpreter. So I want to thank all of you for being here. Let me start with you, Dr. Warshaw. You were here before to talk about the wonderful gala that you had last year, but this is a little different. This is a summit. Can you tell us more about it?
Sure. We are going to be hosting an educational interpreting summit. Mm-hmm. That is going to be next week, October 6th and 7th. Mm-hmm. We will be addressing the topic of the severe issues that we're having with highly qualified and also certified educational interpreters who are working with deaf and hard of hearing students in throughout the state of California.
Do you mean we don't have enough of them?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. We do have a shortage of highly qualified, certified educational interpreters throughout the state.
Okay. The program here at Fresno State, it's addressing this issue, obviously, by teaching the interpretation. Is that right?
Yes. Okay. We do train interpreters.
Okay.
It is a four-year bachelor's degree program.
Okay.
For educational interpreting.
Now, before we talk more about the summit, which you mentioned is happening next week, let me ask Eddie here. You are one of the students in the program. Is that right?
That's right.
Why did you decide to learn interpretation like this?
I've always been doing it since I've been a child with my parents, and they were Spanish-speaking family, so I've always done it since a child, and you know, I just kind of was exposed to sign language a few years ago, and I wanted to include people, and so I took classes, and I just ended up falling in love with the passion of interpreting.
And what would you say to try and encourage others to do the same?
If you really, I feel like it could make a difference, mm-hmm. With communication and give everybody else the access to what everybody else has right now. So. If you love language, if you love analyzing what people say and then converting it into a different language, I'd say you do it. It's so much fun.
And just helping others communicate.
Yes.
It's such a wonderful thing. Dr. Warshaw, there will be two sessions at the summit. Is that right? Can you talk to us about that and what people can expect from the summit?
Sure. On Friday, mm-hmm. we are going to be mainly focusing on school administrators.
Okay.
That includes special education administrators. They need to be aware of the importance of having highly qualified educational interpreters in their schools. Oftentimes, what happens is that there are different hard of hearing students who are struggling to receive full access to their education.
Okay, so are you only inviting administrators to the first session, or is everyone invited, whether or not you might have a child who needs some of the resources, or you're someone who wants to be a part of the program, like Eddie?
Yes, anyone's welcome.
Okay.
Over both days of the summit.
Okay.
We will be focusing on school administrators on Friday. Mm-hmm. And then also we are going to be having a keynote speaker who will be talking about their 30 years of administrative experience as they've worked in the educational setting and also worked in the educational interpreting setting in Orange County.
Wow.
They're speaking on Friday. On Saturday, we're going to have another keynote speaker. It's Dr. Melissa Smith. Mm-hmm. She is a nationally renowned expert in educational interpreting. On Saturday, we are hoping to have a few hundred educational interpreters in attendance, those who are currently working as well as students who are interested in attending. So if parents are interested, any community members, anybody's welcome to attend.
Wonderful, wonderful. And why is Fresno State an ideal place to hold this summit?
Well, we actually did receive a federal grant, over $1 million, and it is the Educational Interpreting Preparation Program, EIPP, that is under the Office of Special Education Program, OSEP. We also are thrilled to be partnering with the California Department of Education.
Wow.
And they are also sponsoring, one of the sponsors of the event. It is also going to be sponsored by the Silent Garden.
Oh, that's fantastic. Well, what a wonderful, wonderful event and a summit, I should say. And it is all happening October 6th and 7th at 9 to 4 at Fresno State's North Gym. Okay, wonderful. Do people need to register any, or do they just show up? Or
I believe on Saturday they can attend,
okay.
Right?
You register and then you should, yeah,
perfect.
Show up. Yeah. Well, listen, Eddie, how many more years do you have before you graduate?
One more year. So,
well, congratulations to you. We need more people like you who are willing to learn really such a wonderful skill.
Yeah.
Wonderful skill.
It's very challenging, but fun.
Okay. Well, thank you for being here, Dr. Warshall. Thank you for being here as well. We appreciate your time, and I'm sure that more great things are happening at Fresno State that you'll let us know when it comes to the Deaf and Hard of Hearing program there.
Yes, thank you so much. I just wanted to add thanks to Dawn Sign Press as well.
Oh, this
is a deaf-owned business that focuses on marketing and selling materials related to deaf culture and American Sign Language. They're also one of the sponsors for our event.
How wonderful.
Yes,
wonderful that the business community is pitching in to help. Thank you all so very much. Appreciate it.